Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, let us start with circular motion. This is very interesting topic, and we'll start with the introduction of circular motion, which is the first chapter of 12th standard. So let us start with the Hello students, let us start with circular motion, and the first topic we'll consider is the introduction to circular motion. So this is the first chapter of 12th standard, and this chapter is circular motion. This is the first chapter of paper 1. Now, what is a circular motion? We have seen particles or bodies moving in different path. It might be in a straight line, it might be in a curved path. We must have seen an object thrown vertically upward, which goes up and comes down. You might have seen the parabolic path of a projectile. Similarly, circular motion means the particle has to move on the circumference of the circle. So the particle has to move on the in a such a way that it moves only in a circular path. So that is the definition of circular motion. When a body moves along the circumference of a circle, motion is said to be circular motion. Let us take a few examples. Motion of hands of a watch. This is circular motion. Means we are talking about any point on the hands, that is suppose the tip of the hand. If you point at the tip moves in a circular path. Not as a whole, this is not moving in a circular path. This body is as a whole is not moving in a circular path. But any point is moving in a circular path. So, and we have one more example of circular motion. We can have various examples like planets around Sun. Though the path is not perfectly circular, in Kepler's laws we have we'll study that the path is elliptical, but for the time being we can consider planet's motion around Sun is circular. Similarly, we have got electrons around the nucleus. So inside the atom, the electrons are moving in a circular path around the nucleus. We might have seen, we can have various examples. You can rotate a stone tying with a thread or a string attached to one end, and the other end is held, and it is whirled in a horizontal circle or a vertical circle. This is also circular motion. Motion of a stone tied around the string. World in horizontal or vertical plane. So there can be various examples of circular motion. Now let us then go to the next part that we'll discuss. So this is all about the introduction part of the circular motion. The particle is obviously moving in a curve, so it is a curvilinear motion. And next we'll discuss the parameters involved in circular motion. In case of a linear motion, when a body is moving, or translatory motion, the body is moving in a straight line, and the distance is changing with time. A body moves in a straight line away from any observer, certainly the distance is increasing. And when the body approaches the observer in a straight line, the distance decreases. It might go away and come back, that may happen, but if all things happen in a straight line, then we say that the parameter that is changing is the distance, or in terms of displacement also you can say is changing. So here in translatory motion we discuss about linear motion, and because of the linear motion the parameters involved are linear displacement. The linear displacement is considered, the linear word is used there. The velocity, how fast the distance is changing. If it is changing, covering a certain distance in small time, then we say that the speed is more or the velocity is more. If it takes more time, then the velocity is less. But that velocity is called linear velocity. Similarly, the acceleration, which involves the rate of change of velocity, that acceleration is called linear acceleration. So these are the terminology used for linear motions or translatory motions. But when a particle moves, keeps on moving in a circular path, its distance remains fixed about the point of rotation. This particle is moving in a circular path, its distance from fixed points, the center of circle, will remain same. So therefore we should not say that the distance is changing. We have to introduce angular parameters, that is the distance or displacement in this case is not linear, the displacement is angular displacement, the velocity involved will be angular velocity, and the acceleration will be angular acceleration. That we will discuss in the next video. So let us, we will start with that. Okay, thank you.